Now here's your host of This Is, John and Bill.
Hey, we're at another great amusement park, aren't we?
Yes, we are. We're outside of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, in a little town called West Mifflin. And you know what that means, John.
That means we're at Kennywood.
Yes, we are. And this is a great park. It's been here for many, many years. And they have a great sense of history at this park, don't they, John?
Yes, they do. They have a little bit of the old mixed with a little bit of the new, a little bit of refurbished, a little bit of add-on, a little bit of everything. It's a very unique little park. Great dark rides, great coaster collection, classic and modern.
That's true. They have some new modern coasters here, as well as a lot of old wood and things like that. They've got some unique rides here, one of which is their Tumblebug ride, which is one of only two left in the country. And they also have the Auto Race, which I believe is the only one in existence.
That's right. That was specially designed and made for this park, I believe.
I believe you're correct in that.
And without further ado, this is
Kennywood.
All right, here we are in the front entrance plaza area. This is just outside the park.
Yeah, that's right. We're here. This is an area that they spruced up a few years back. They gave it a whole new feel, and I'll tell you what, it's a really nice feel here.
Yes, it's a really great location. Here we are in the back of the Lost Kennywood section.
Yeah, this was actually a nice section that they added. It's meant to look like an older amusement park, such as a Luna Park.
Yeah, they had a lot of the same type of features with the water fountains and the Shoot the Curls ride. It's a very classic application.
And of course we see Phantom's Revenge here in the background.
That's right, one of several of their coasters. It's a great way of getting yourself cooled off by riding the Pittsburgh Plunge.
Yeah, this is a good way to keep cool on a hot day around in Pittsburgh, I'll tell you what. So, but they've kept this section really nice, and of course there's a little drying station around in case the Pittsburgh Plunge gets you a little too wet, more than what you'd like to be, so.
Here's another view of the Pittsburgh Plunge looking towards the ride. As I said, these water fountains are really, really nice. It helps keep this area of the park cool.
Yeah, that's right. And also to the right there, you might see one of the legs of their big spinning disc ride here.
The Black Widow.
That's right. And here's some people getting nice and wet on a hot day in Pittsburgh.
And here is Exterminator.
Well, everyone, I'm here at Kennywood, and I just got off of the Exterminator ride. This ride is something special. You're in the dark, you're spinning around, just wonderful. You basically are the rat. And they are trying to exterminate you any way that is possible. And it's a very interesting waiting queue. There's a little button in there. If you push it at the right time, you may get a very interesting reaction from people in the crowd, as well as the lights in the area where you're waiting. So what I would suggest you do is come out here to Kennywood, ride this unique ride, and have fun. And remember, this is Kennywood.
Here we are on the whip. This is a real classic ride for this area.
That's right. This ride's been around for many, many years. It used to have a covering over top of it, but Mother Nature had other aspirations for this ride and decided to modify that by taking the top off of it.
Yeah, she really knew how to raise the roof.
But, this is done well here. It's on the standard wooden platform with some steel sheeting over top of that, which definitely reduces the noise level of these rides.
Yeah, if you didn't have that and if it was on concrete, refer to our Hershey Park show, you'll understand why that is a bad idea.
That's right, but this is a classic ride. It whips you around, and you really get a nice feeling off of it, and a lot of people enjoying it here, as we can see right now.
I believe it's one of the faster of the rides, too.
I think so. It's also nice to get really close to your sweetheart there, if you're so inclined.
That is true.
Of course, that building in the background there is the Exterminator building as well, if we haven't mentioned that previously.
Here we are in part of the games midway. The games area is pretty much separated into, I believe, two sections. There's a small section in the Lost Kennywood area, and then there's a larger section in the main part of the amusement park.
Yeah, this is the small section in Lost Kennywood, and of course there you have the dryer. That also gives you a shot of the tower where Black Widow is, and we go over to a kind of event.
Here's another angle from the opposite side of the Fountain Plaza.
You did see a little bit of Wave Swinger there as well, which is a Kennywood classic.
Oh, of course. And here we are with the Black Widow. This ride is big. I mean, big. I've seen smaller versions of this, and they're quite fun. This one is also amazing fun, but it is, as I said, big. You get some major swings off of this thing.
Yeah, this will take you up and swing you around, and you go really, really high on this thing. Because it's big.
The thing that it's hard to get over is the psychological impact that this ride has. Because you see those very small, spindly legs that this is supporting this entire pendulum, and it makes you double think, is this a good idea?
Well, this actually replaced a ride that was at Kennywood for many years as well. It replaced a drop tower. But the drop tower, of course, sometimes was working, sometimes was not, and the decision was made. And I think it was a good decision that was made to replace it with something of this nature.
Yes, one of the major malfunctions of it was to get to the top of the tower and not drop. That's usually a problem when there's people inside the cars. So they replaced it with this ride, and it's been, I hate to say it, but a swinging good time ever since. Here's a small section of the Thunderbolt, the second oldest coaster inside the park. I'm going to give you a couple more angles about that, and I believe one of us is going to have a little talk about this coaster with you in just a moment.
Yeah, this part of the Thunderbolt here is actually the ending of the ride, believe it or not. We'll explain a little more about the beginning of the ride in just a moment here.
Thank you.
Wow, I just got off of a really great coaster. I got off the Thunderbolt here. Let me tell you, for an older coaster, it really packs a punch. It throws you around. You come right out of the station and go directly into a drop. I don't know hardly any other coaster that I know does that. Listen to the sound of that monster behind me. This is great. I can't believe it. And this coaster originally started its life as a coaster called the Pippin. They changed it. It has some of the original parts, but not many. But I'll tell you what, you have a great coaster and you can ride it right here at Kennywood. Remember, this is Kennywood.
Here we are at another look at one of the midways here. You have the potato patch there, and what's that in the background?
I believe that's Ghostwood Estates, which is a great dark ride that they have here in the park now.
Here's a delicacy that, as far as I know, was original to Kennywood.
That's right. I believe the deep-fried Oreos, they actually started having these here, and then now other parks have started to pick up on it. But these are the originals, folks. These are good.
Now, the picture doesn't do it justice. I'm going to tell you that much. You think of Oreos as being these hard little brown wafer cookies that we all love. But when you put those in delicious batter and you deep fry these things, oh boy.
They become this like decadent, ooey gooey loveliness of sweet, and yeah, it's just to die for.
These cookies turn into cake. As hard as that is to believe, that's what happens to them. Okay, here we are at the Parkside Cafe. It's a wonderful building. We'll give you a shot here of the building here in just a moment. But the food there is reasonably priced and plentiful.
Oh, yes. We went there for lunch this day, and I had a meatloaf. And what did you have for?
I had elbow pasta with meatballs, a breadstick, and I think I even had a piece of chocolate cake of some sort, or pie.
Yeah, that's right. And I'll tell you what, I mean, this meal, for the price that you're going to pay at a regular amusement park for this meal, it's not even close to that. I mean, you get great value here, and you're getting good food.
Yes, it's so hard to go to a amusement park and then get served mediocre food. There's no time for that. You said, so find, when you do find a place like this, give them the money and love that's necessary. So here we are at another look at the cafe, and as you can tell, they have a wonderful press tin ceiling. Easy for me to say.
Yeah, well, this is a historic building. It's been here for many, many years. It's seen some changes, but it's a building that if you want to get out of the heat of the day and go have a nice meal, sit down meal with your family, it's the perfect place to do that.
Yes, it is. It's a cafeteria-style service. But if all cafeterias were like this, there would be no problem with that type of service at all. Here we are outside of the potato patch, and boy, are we going to be having a treat here.
Oh yes, this is a staple at Kennywood. As you can see by the line of people, they're good.
Oh yeah. I think you have a couple words you're going to say about these, aren't you, Bill?
Yes, I am.
Well, folks, we have shown you the deep-fried Oreos. We've also shown you a great meal that we had at the Parkside Cafe. Well, here's a strange concoction. What we have here are fresh-cut French fries, but they're smothered in a beef stock gravy. Just absolute decadence. Well, let me tell you, I'm not sure whether it's a French-Canadian influence on them, but for some reason, in this section of the country, they like to have their French fries here with gravy. Or they also have it with cheese and bacon, if you like it that way. But this is the very unique item at this park that you can only get here. And where's here, you say? Right here? Remember, this is K. Kennywood.
Here we have the turtle ride here at Kennywood.
Yeah, the turtle. It's a tumblebug ride. Now, this is one of only two that are remaining in operation in the entire world.
It's sort of a hard ride to get a photograph of because it's in the middle of the hollow here of the Phantom's Revenge, and it's sort of, it's just a hard place to get a photo of it. It's a wonderful ride, though. Here we have the Phantom's Revenge. It is the king of this amusement park. That goes without speaking. This is probably the only real good way that you can get a good look at this coaster.
That's right. And that's just because it uses a lot of the terrain, the valley that was actually in Kennywood. And also now, an interesting fact about this coaster is it's a coaster that was built by Aerodynamics, and then it was changed later by the Morgan Company.
That's right. And this is prior to the Chance buying Morgan, which subsequently bought all the designs and everything of the Morgan coasters. This has probably one of the top three slowest lift hills. It just builds suspense all the way through it.
And as you can see, the first drop is a turning drop. And then you'll go up over the second hill and down into the valley.
And we got a shot of that here coming up.
Yeah, this coaster has really become, well, it was the king when it was the Steel Phantom, but it's definitely the king now. And here we have a shot of the lift hill, and this has a very unique car design as well.
Oh, yeah. It's I think we like calling it a sidearm cars, because the pad comes straight across your lap. It's accessible to people of any type of body size, and I do mean any type, but hold on. This is a ride not to be trifled with. You will be going crazy on it.
Thank you. We're going to let it speak for itself right here. So go ahead and watch the Phantom with us.
That's the Phantom's Revenge, folks. It's almost too fast for its own good, because you want more. And I think I have a couple words about this ride.
You know, I'll tell you what, folks. I just got off the Phantom's Revenge, and you want to talk about one heck of a coaster. I mean, you're up and out of your seat, you're in your seat, you're out of your seat, you're going around hard turns, speed, down into a valley. I don't think it gets much better than this, because this is Kennywood.
Another shot of one of the midways here with Noah's Ark in the background.
That's right, and this Noah's Ark, it's the last one remaining. There's no others like it.
If you don't know what a Noah's Ark is, there's several little scenes inside of it, and they've sort of made this one a little high-tech as well, with a couple of additional scenes that are pretty psychologically traumatizing.
Now we have a new school type of dark ride. This is Ghostwood Estates here, and this is a Sally-designed attraction with trackless vehicles.
Yeah, this is a lot like your Disney-style rides. It's a Zapper ride. I'm not really big into Zapper rides, but this is one of the better ones out there. I would like to see more of a, how do we put it, more of a design of an old spook house, but have more of the Disney flair to it. The Zappers are getting old. Here we are at Kiddyland. We're just going to take a real quick tour through Kiddyland, let it speak for itself, because frankly, it's a Kiddyland. You've seen one. How many more do you need to see?
Yeah, but for the younger children, I mean, Kennywood has a very large Kiddyland here. The classic Humphrey-style rides and things like that. But, you know, it's a good way to keep your kids entertained while you're there if they can't ride some of the larger things at Kennywood. Here we're going to give you an overview. They have a giant sand pit, as usual. We're also coming up on, they have a Snackosaurus here, which is a small concession stand there. But it's your basic kiddie land.
Here we have the Auto Racer. This is a treat.
That's right. Now, this was originally built in the 1930s. This is the last of its kind remaining.
Yeah. Basically, it's a giant slot car, electric slot car. It's just fun. Sometimes the cars are a little bit hard to get into, but if you can, you got to give it a shot.
And as we follow this little gentleman here around, the kids seem to like it because it's their first time to actually get to, quote-unquote, drive a car. This originally had some hills in the track, and the cars were a little bit of a different style. Now, the hills were removed, from what I understand, somewhere in 1948. And that was just because some of the cars during rainstorms and things were not making it up the hill, and they were having some minor fender benders with them rolling back down from the hill. Also, the cars were redesigned in the 50s to look more like a race car.
Then it was also given another boost during the 90s.
Yes, that's right. In the 90s, they had a local artist by the name of Ralph Pantalone, and his wife Kathleen came in. They were able to repaint the facade, you know, redo the facade, and they painted some numbers on the sides of the cars, racing numbers and things like that. So you also have a local artist being involved with a classic ride here at Kennywood.
Laughing Sal.
Yeah, this was added during the 1920s as a, basically to laugh off your troubles during the Depression.
And a lot of the attractions here have historical placards next to them. And the, if you don't want to take our word, it's right there. It's in black and white. You can try to look at it if you want to. But that's actually a great benefit because a lot of these places, they have a great history and they really don't tell you about it.
Now here we are on the racer, the little racer section of the Midway. Now the racer is a great coaster. This is a nice little section they have it in. That's the original facade, and they found that when they took off the facade that was put there in the 50s or 60s, I believe it was.
It was literally just covered up.
Yep. And you're going to see the racer here in a minute. Yeah, here we go. Now, this is a continuous track. It's one track with two trains on the same track.
If that's not enough to warp your mind, I don't know what else there is out there. But I'm going to give you a couple more words on this ride. And believe me, it warped my mind. You probably will agree with it. Here's a shot of the racer. It's actually a copy of the Euclid Beach Racer, a little bit smaller in scale, but it's basically the same exact layout.
Yeah, that's right. And you're only going to see a Mobius coaster like this one other place, and I believe that's in Mexico.
Yes, it's Mexico City, Mexico. It's a Six Flags park now. And that's the only other one. That's the largest of the type, but the original racer at Euclid Beach was actually larger than that. So it's pretty impressive. There's photos of it out on the web. Take a look at it. You'll be impressed.
I think you're going to talk to us about this coaster, aren't you, John?
Yeah. I think I had another episode here.
You know, there are some times that you have strange roller coasters. One behind me here. It's a continuous track. One loop of track, no waiting. Start on the right side and up on the left side. It will warp your mind. Don't try thinking about it, just ride it, enjoy it. Great airtime, a lot of nice lateral G's. But seriously, don't think about it. If you do, if you think about this ride, it will drive you insane. So please, whatever you do, do not think about the ride, all right? Just ride it, just ride it. Because this is Kennywood.
Hey everybody, I just got off of the Jackrabbit here at Kennywood. Oh my lord, it was absolutely awesome. This coaster is an old wooden coaster, but I'll tell you what, for a coaster, it runs with the terrain and even has a double down that will have you out of your seat. I mean, out of your seat. So if you get a chance, come out here to Kennywood and ride the Jackrabbit. And remember, this is Kennywood.
We are at the Garfield's Revenge, Garfield's Nightmare. Oh boy.
That's okay. Yeah, it is a nightmare for Garfield. But yeah, this ride has been around basically a very, very long time. It was originally titled the Old Mill.
I believe this is one of the original rides to the entire amusement park, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, I believe it was. However, don't get it confused. It was never called the Tunnel of Love.
No, it was not. It's just a, I guess you would call it a tribute to one of Garfield's more active imagination periods.
And now here we are at the carousel at Kennywood.
Yes, and we're just going to let this carousel speak for itself. And so enjoy the music, and we'll get back to you on the other side of this.
Thank you.
Here we are at one of the other eateries at Kennywood.
That's right. And this one's actually placed in an old carousel house.
They've had several carousels here at the park, and all that's left is the houses for them. Some of them were monster machines, too, by the looks of it. Here we have a statue. What's unique about this statue? Well, it's of George Washington.
That's correct. He had several things that happened in Pennsylvania associated with George Washington, in this particular area, in fact.
Right. It was during the French and Indian War that he was in this area.
And this is really Kennywood at its best. This is like a garden park, basically.
Yeah. Most people don't... When you go to amusement parks, you're not thinking... You're thinking rides, you're thinking attractions. This is like going to a city park that someone happened to put rides in.
Yeah. But it's very beautiful as well.
Oh, yes.
Cosmic Chaos!
It's your disco ride done to aliens, UFOs, that type of thing.
Yeah, it's a good theming. Here's a little bit of the chaos. Obviously, the aliens are trying to steal a piece of Kennywood for themselves to take back to their planet.
Yeah, yeah. Didn't they realize that those boxes have expiration dates on them? Ooh.
Apparently not. But as you'll see here, I think this is the large disco track with a smaller disco disc.
Yeah, yeah, this one gets a little bit more altitude on it. If you're into lunch reviews, great ride. If you're not, stay off of it. Be kind to others.
Yeah, this is just not our cup of tea, folks, but if it's yours, then by all means, have at, because I've been on it. It's a decently fun ride for me, once in a while.
Yeah. It does not agree with me at all. I'll tell you that right now. Woe of weak stomach, watch.
We shall not mention that.
Sorry about that again, Bill. As always at Kennywood, we don't show you any of the live entertainment because we don't have the permission to do so. So all we can actually show you is the rides. But they do have some good live entertainment here. Come and see it. Here we are looking at the volcano. It's an Enterprise in a volcano. Or is that a silver bullet? Or is that a witch's wheel? Or is it the other five names that goes by?
But we have a small gift shop here, and then we come to the Barren Curve.
Get ready to scream, folks.
Now this ride, if you grew up in the 70s, you know this ride. They've had several over the years in different parks, but this is one of the few remaining. It was in storage for quite a few years. They refurbished it and brought it back out.
Yeah, this sucker gets insane. When you hit top speed, they have a horn that sounds... And you're about ready to scream yourself at that point in time. It is simply intense. It doesn't look like it's intense. It is intense.
Trust me, you won't be able to lift your arms. You won't be able to move your legs. You're in the seat.
Oh, yeah. Here's the newest roller coaster here at the park.
That's right. This is Skyrocket. Now, this is a Premier Rides. They're using a short train. This coaster is about 2,100 feet long, 95 feet high. Only goes about 50 miles an hour. That's not a whole lot, right? think about this. Small footprint, three different inversions, and all these twists and turns and S-curves and things like that. It's a fun ride.
Oh, it is a blast. I would like to see more of these smaller coasters like this in parks, but it doesn't seem like anyone wants to do the small anymore. They want to do the giant coasters. There's a place for these, and thankfully Kennywood found a place for it.
I just got off of Skyrocket at Kennywood Amusement Park. This thing is absolutely amazing. You have such a coaster. Yeah, it's a short train, but you have it, and it does twists, turns, rolls, dives. It does all of it, and it does it in a compact footprint. You need to come ride this ride. It'll give you the ride of your life, I'm telling you. It's great. So come out to Kennywood and ride Skyrocket. And remember, this is Kennywood.
Boy, this was a pretty good park for the money.
Oh yeah, I mean, I can't complain. For the amount of rides that we got to ride today, all the neat experiences that we got to have, and don't forget to mention the food too.
Oh yeah, the food was absolutely wonderful, and you saw that too.
Well, you know, I mean, this park has been here since 1898, and throughout the years they've adapted and gotten new things, but they have a sense of history here, and they have kept the old stuff as well.
Yes, they always have a way of making something basically out of nothing. I mean, they had two dark rides, they refurbished them, redone them, and they made them even better. Now, you should come here because it is a great park. Come here for the great rides. Just come here. Okay? Because as we all know, once these places are gone, they're gone. So come out to a small park near you, or maybe one of the larger ones. But the idea is, come out to a park.
Yeah, you're what keeps these small parks going. You know, keeping the traditions, keeping the history, helping them to improve. Come, visit your small park. Give them money. They need it.
Yes. And remember, to bring the sunscreen, we actually forgot, and so we are a little on the crispy side here, but people would say that about other things too. But hey, this is, or I should say, this was Kennywood.
The proceeding has been brought to you by This Is, under a Creative Commons Attribution Non-Commercial Share-Alike License 2.5. Some rights reserved. Special thanks go to Kane Live Editing Software. You can find Kane Live at www.kanelive.org.